Good evening, dear friends, dear parents, and everyone listening to us. Today again, we are here with the Parenting Tip of the Week. And on this panel today, we have a special guest, Mrs. Seema Bhatia. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Harsha.
To introduce Seema, ma'am, I would say that she's in this education field for more than 40 years. And I had the privilege to work with her for many, many years, and you have been one of the greatest motivators of my life.
Thank you so much for giving me this, what to say, the respect and honor.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Today's parenting tip is over-shielding or over-protecting a child, ma'am.
See, Harsha, as per your topic, as teachers we have observed over the years that far from growing to be a strong and a tough individual, our children are becoming increasingly fragile. And this trend is being reinforced by the society. Society means the prime are the parents. Much has been said about over-parenting, helicopter parenting, but it's high time now that we need to tell the parents to stop protecting their children from the life's changes of circumstances or fortune. They are not the fortune maker. Children must be allowed to feel sad or disappointed at times and to learn to cope up with setbacks, failures, defeats, and this is how the fragility factor can be addressed.
I mean, today's parents, you feel, ma'am, they don't allow the child to become sad for a moment. Anything the child asks, it's given to them.
That is that the child is always, you know, in a cocoon built by the parent. That happy comfort zone.
Yes. And a general notion is that you can only spoil a child by giving him overabundance of materialistic things.
Very true.
And helping them to keep up with their class or neighborhood to be the prime person. But spoiling can happen in other ways also. By trying to keep the child constantly happy and cheerful. In other words, taking down all the downs of his life and sanitizing the child spells disaster for the child's future. The child will never be able to cope up with in the face of adversities, which is bound to confront every individual sooner or later.
Very true, ma'am. And I think failure is a part and parcel of life.
Yes.
So I think the parents should introduce their children to failure also.
Yes.
It can be a failure of a small competition in a school, Pooja.
Yeah, definitely it should be a failure of, like a child participating in a competition. See, winners are always there. But that does not mean that if a child loses, the mother should take it to the heart. In fact, after a competition, the winners are discussed why she is the winner, why she is not the winner.
They become very judgmental about the result also.
Why it is judged?
They are only concerned about the result.
The judges, and the performance is ignored at all. It's not even talked about.
The judges are there, the teachers are doing the work, the principal herself is there. Then why there is so much discussed about for everything?
I think in fact what should happen if the child wins or loses, the discussion should be about the performance the child has given.
Yes. In that circumstances with his peer group, how he has performed so that the child feels happy.
Yeah.
That yes, I was a performer and my parents were not concerned with the winning or losing.
Right. And the reaction of the parents also, sometimes it happens ke bacha itna wo ho jata hai ki does not want to share. Suppose that the parents present nahi hai competition, and if the child loses, then it happens ki bacha ghar pe ja ke bolne mein bhi hichkichata hai.
Bilkul. ये सिर्फ परफॉर्मेंसेस और उसमें नहीं, इवन स्टडीज में पेरेंट्स कहते हैं उसने छुपा दिया रिजल्ट, दिखाया नहीं, बट बिकॉज द चाइल्ड इज वेरी वेल अवेयर ऑफ हिज पेरेंट्स आर गोइंग टू गेट डिस्टर्ब, ही विल बी द अल्टीमेट, यू कैन से, जिसके ऊपर गाज गिरेगी. तो वो क्या करता है, चीजें छुपाने लगता है अपने पेरेंट्स से, और फिर पेरेंट्स बच्चे को ही ब्लेम करते हैं, एंड दे देमसेल्फ ऑल्सो. आई टेल यू अ स्टोरी ऑफ अ फादर. एज आई टोल्ड, a sports meet was there, the child did not win. After the program was over, the father took the child to the winning stand, made him stand on that winning and took a photograph. Now it seems to be a very,
very
normal
thing,
but no, the father was not helping his son to learn that you win sometimes and you lose sometimes, because parents are so intensely career oriented or achievement oriented that they do not want their child to lose. So children are not growing up with the normal doses of failure as well as success, or they are not made for the hit and trial and error method also. Koshish to karo, गलत हो जाएगा तो कोई बात नहीं,
मतलब गलती की तो कोई गुंजाइश ही नहीं होती आज
के। यू शुड कम आउट विद अ परफेक्ट एंड विद द टॉप मोस्ट, बट यू आर नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड कि नहीं, तुम यू जस्ट प्रिपेयर योर सेल्फ टू रीच देयर, फिर देखेंगे तुम वहां जाने की कोशिश तो करो, वो नहीं होता।
और मैम कभी कभी ये भी तो होता है ना मैम कि बच्चे इसलिए भी छुपाते हैं क्योंकि बच्चे पेरेंट्स को ज्यादा जानते हैं कि एक्चुअली पेरेंट्स हैंडल नहीं कर सकते फेलियर।
यस, बोलते हैं बच्चे हम लोगों को, बोलते हैं कि भाई माय पेरेंट्स विल स्कोल्ड मी, आई डू नॉट, एंड व्हाट डू? दे हाइड द थिंग्स एंड अल्टीमेटली व्हाट हैपेंस, दे डू गो एंड डू समथिंग terrible, it is because of the
parents pressure because parents cannot handle the failure.
So in the face of humiliation they go, and tragedy is that more and more children are doing these terrible things.
मतलब हमारे जमाने में ऐसा होता था ना मैम, ये बहुत छोटी छोटी बातें होती थी जिसको पेरेंट्स कभी डिस्कस भी नहीं करते थे।
नाउ द चिल्ड्रन हैव बिकम सो थिन स्किन्ड दैट एवरी लिटिल थिंग इज बिकमिंग अ सीरियस इशू फॉर देम।
वेरी ट्रू, वेरी ट्रू। मतलब हर छोटी सी चीज के लिए पेरेंट्स को भी एक एक्सप्लेनेशन चाहिए, ये क्यों हो गया, ये क्यों नहीं हुआ। राइट पूजा, व्हाट आई एम सेइंग,
टीचर कैन नॉट टेल डायरेक्टली एनीथिंग टू द चाइल्ड। दूसरे दिन आ जाता है कि यू टॉक दिस वे टू द माई,
मतलब टीचर्स को फ्रीडम नहीं है अपने हिसाब से बच्चे को मोल्ड करने के लिए।
द चाइल्ड कुड नॉट स्लीप होल नाइट बिकॉज द टीचर हैज अ लाउड पिच ऑफ,
मतलब इतना भी बच्चा ले नहीं सकता है।
व्हाई डू द चिल्ड्रन हैव टू बी प्रेज्ड ऑल द टाइम, व्हाई द टीचर इज नॉट हैविंग दिस स्पॉन्टेनियस स्कोलिंग कैन बी देयर
बिकॉज ऑफ द पेरेंट्स बिहेवियर, के पेरेंट्स टोटल टेलिंग यू डोंट नो हाउ टू बिहेव फॉर द चाइल्ड, यू ऑलवेज हैव टू पैम्पर द चाइल्ड बिकॉज उसको कुछ बुरा ना लग जाए।
डोंट यू थिंक दिस पैम्परिंग लीड्स टू अ वेरी फ्रेजाइल चाइल्ड?
आई एग्री विद मैम दैट डेफिनेटली
संभाल के रखो कहीं टूट ना जाए, संभाल के रखो कहीं टूट ना जाए। और जब लाइफ में,
और कब तक संभालोगे उसको, कब तक संभालोगे
लाइफ की रेस में जब छोड़ोगे तो कब तक आप उसकी फ्रेजिलिटी को रख पाओगे?
अ कैजुअल रिमार्क ट्रिगर्स ऑफ सो मेनी यू नो चेन रिएक्शंस विद द काउंसलर्स विद द साइकोलॉजिस्ट दैट वी हैव टेकन टू द चाइल्ड, एज यू सेड कि नॉट एबल टू स्लीप अप, वी हैड टू गिव द मेडिसिन, द डॉक्टर सेड द टीचर्स मस्ट हैव सेड समथिंग। सो एवरी चाइल्ड मस्ट लर्न टू टेक क्रिटिसिज्म एंड नॉट टेक एवरी कैजुअल और लाइट हार्टेड कमेंट्स टू बी वेरी सीरियस टू देयर हार्ट।
वेरी ट्रू।
एवरी चाइल्ड मस्ट लर्न टू स्टैंड टू अप टू हिज ओन प्रिंसिपल्स एंड एक्सप्रेस हिज ओन ओपिनियन व्हेन इट रियली मैटर्स।
वेरी ट्रू। Pooja, anything you would like to add?
Yeah, definitely I would like to say that the children should always learn for, they should be prepared to for all the phases of life. The youth we are expecting for tomorrow's India. Like, I will always say the parents that children are masterpieces in their way. Don't run behind them to make them showpieces in the world.
Very true. And as you, we are earlier talking, ma'am, ki schools mein bachon ko, apart from academics, children are taught to be a complete human being.
Yes.
We are the molders of the children.
Yes.
So at times failure से उनका परिचय कराना, उनको failure में वो कैसा react करते हैं, उनको उनके हाल पर छोड़ना, थोड़ा रोना, वो सब भी parents को सिखाना चाहिए बच्चों को।
Yes.
लेकिन today's parents, children are fragile, parents are more fragile.
And you know, more dealing has to be with the parents rather than with the children. Because in the whole day during our teaching career, we have never shouted at children for unnecessary reasons. And we talk to the children in a normal way because we accept this is the way they are going to do because they are the children. But and children, that is why they love their teachers. They love their teachers saying that my parents are taking things in a different way than what my teacher is taking. So, a school has always been looked upon as a place where children are helped to attain academic and non-scholastic areas and achievements. But school is traditionally a place where a character is built. A school is a place where equal importance for the child is there to fair, to learn to play fair, to accept the failures, and to win gracefully, to respond to failures positively, and to take the ups and downs of his life.
I mean, we should prepare a child or our children in that way that they should be able to take up failure very easily. It should be a very normal thing.
Yeah, because it is a normal thing.
It is a normal thing.
Success is only because failure is there.
Very true, very true. And failure, I mean, the parents, I always request the parents, ki whenever you are taking children for participating them for any competition or any school test, if you react very normally for any
the
failure,
child performance is going to be enhanced.
I mean, what happens, you know, after the competition also in the school, the parents are discussing the result of the competition. In fact, I tell the parent ki agar bacche ka result nahi aaya, usne part liya, us baat ko celebrate karo. भूल जाओ, बच्चे को बोलो दूसरी बार आएगा नंबर, और नंबर लाना इम्पोर्टेंट
नहीं है। नंबर लाने लाने में कितना कुछ छोड़ रहे पीछे, वी आर फॉरगेटिंग टू मेक देम गुड पीपल, गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग, वी आर फॉरगेटिंग ऑल दोस थिंग्स टू इंकल्केट इन अ चाइल्ड,
इन अ चाइल्ड, वेरी
सो दे शुड ट्रस्ट द स्कूल, दे शुड लेट द स्कूल डू इट्स वर्क ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग अप अ स्ट्रांग एंड टफ पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ अ चाइल्ड,
राइट,
एंड constant interference and overprotection is only going to result in weak and fragile child of today and a immature
adult
of tomorrow.
Very true. With this, we wrap up today's video by giving a message. Overprotecting child will always lead to disaster, as ma'am said, an immature adult. So next time when you take your children for participating in anything, do concentrate on the participation of the child, not the winning and the losing. If you take winning and losing a very normal thing, the children are definitely going to do the same. Thank you, Seema ma'am, for
being with us. My pleasure. Thank you. It was a pleasure for me.
Thank you for listening to us. Thank you.